everyone. Welcome to Cherry Clips. Today, I'll be sharing a fantasy movie named Fortuna's Eye. When Steven was little, he suffered in a plane accident. He's the only survivor of his family. Since then, he possesses the Fortuna's Eye, an ability where he can see through people who are about to die. People whose death drawing near appear transparent to him. After he grows up, he becomes a car mechanic. He has worked assiduously in a garage for 10 years. His hard work wins the trust of his boss, so the boss decides to promote him to the manager of the branch. But Steven faces an embarrassing condition, because a colleague named Dean has also worked in this garage for many years. He also wants to be the branch's manager, so he is jealous of Steven. Though Steven gives up his chance of promotion, his repaired car is scraped and smeared by Dean deliberately. During their debate, Dean pushes Steven to the ground, causing his phone screen to crack. At night, Steven goes to a phone store to repair his phone. There, he meets a lovely girl named Alice. She applies a new screen protector on his phone to protect it from scratches. Steven thanks her, and he is attracted to her. The next night, on his way to meet Alice, Steven sees a man become transparent. He follows him to see what will happen. However, the man is abruptly hit by a car and killed right in front of Steven. That scene shocks him violently. His mind is still absent when he works the next day. Later, Steven's phone is out of work again. He goes to the phone store where Alice works and wants to buy a new one. However, when he hands his phone to Alice to copy the data in it, he finds her hands start to be transparent. A feeling of nervousness and fear seizes him, because that means Alice will die from misfortune. He immediately invites her to have coffee. When Alice meets him at the coffee shop as appointed, Steven finds she is not transparent. He breathes a sigh of relief. Looking at Alice, who is confused, Steven tells her that he can see through others' bodies, but he doesn't explain to her more details. After he leaves the coffee shop, he suddenly feels a heartache. Looking at Alice in the shop, he realizes that he has to work harder because he wants to give his loved girl a happy life. So the next day, Steven agrees to be the branch's manager and starts to work earnestly. At night, Alice pays a visit to Steven. She says the chemical plant which she passes by every day had an explosion yesterday. If Steven didn't invite her to have a coffee, she would be injured yesterday. So she comes to express her thanks to him. That makes Steven proud. He realizes that his special ability could protect his loved girl. Then he becomes more confident and open. The wife of Steven's boss is delighted with his changes, because Steven was so self-contempt and timid before. He once met a girl and fell in love with her. However, due to his feeling of inferiority, he had no courage to confess to her. At last, the girl became another's girlfriend. The branch runs well under Steven's management. One day when he visits the head garage, he sees the boss is scolding Dean. The boss decides to fire Dean because he drives a customer's car without permission. Dean bristles with rage. He vents his spite upon Steven, hitting him heavily with repairing tools. Seeing that, the boss gives Dean a punch and expels him out of the garage. However, at this moment, Steven sees the boss is becoming transparent. That means he is about to die. So Steven keeps guarding him at his side. Sure enough, danger falls on him. On the boss's way home, Dean abruptly appears and intends to hit him. Fortunately, Steven immediately comes out in front of the boss and protects him from being hurt. But after he saves the boss, Steven feels an extreme pain in his chest. Finally, he faints on the ground and is taken to the hospital. After a series of examinations, doctors find all functions of his body are normal. At the corridor of the hospital, Steven tries to save a little girl who is becoming transparent. But at this moment, a doctor appears and stops him. In fact, this doctor has the same ability as him. He tells Stephen that though they have the ability to see through the body of people who are about to die, they can't interfere and change their fate. Otherwise, they themselves will pay a high price for it. Hearing that, Stephen knows he can't control the life and death of others. He realizes he should pay more attention to his own life. So the first thing he does is make a confession to Alice. Alice happily agrees to be his girlfriend. Then they become lovers and start to date. In addition, Stephen intercedes with the boss for Dean and employs him again. Dean is moved by Stephen's magnanimity, but whenever Stephen recalls the suffering at the childhood, he would become nervous and incredulous about the present happiness. Alice keeps comforting him and helps open his heart. At last, Stephen thinks things through and decides to make a proposal to Alice. But after he buys rings for the proposal, his heart suddenly feels ill, so he goes to the hospital for an examination. He is diagnosed with a chronic disease called stenocardia. The doctor warns him that the disease is the price he needs to pay for his interference with others' fate. Hearing that, Stephen decides not to meddle in others' fate. One day, a frequent customer comes to the garage. This man is the boyfriend of the girl who Stephen liked before. Stephen inquires about the girl. The man says the girl had spent all the money on him and then had become a whore. Knowing Stephen's concerns about the girl, the man mocks and depreciates him. Dean is angry and wants to hit the man for Stephen. But considering he is their frequent customer, Stephen stops Dean and serves him politely. The next day, when the man comes to pick up his car, Stephen sees his hands are becoming transparent. At first, Stephen wants to warn him, but thinking about the doctor's exhortation and the man's evil doing to that girl, Stephen chooses to be reticent. As expected, the man dies later. At his funeral, Stephen sees his family crying sadly. That makes Stephen feel guilty. After going home, he is still indulged in the feeling of grief. Alice tries to comfort him, but Stephen is totally immersed in the extreme emotion. He can't listen to anything. He angrily rejects Alice's good intention. After Alice leaves, Stephen startledly wakes from the dream in which the scene of the plane incident appears again. The next day, on the train, Stephen sees all passengers are becoming transparent. The same is true of the children near the station. Then he sees a leaflet about family excursion on the ground. He realizes these children and passengers he saw on the train this morning will meet at a particular time. Looking at the time of the family excursion on the leaflet, he finds the train will have an accident the day after tomorrow. At night, Stephen apologizes to Alice for he has vented anger at her that day, but he suddenly sees her hands also become transparent. In order to prevent this disaster, he invites Alice to take a trip with him. Then he calls the kindergarten and asks them to change the time of the family excursion. However, he suffers a heartache again. He comes to the hospital and asks the doctor to predict his fate. The doctor says nothing, but exhorts him for the misfortune that will fall on him if he continues to interfere in others' fate. However, Stephen still wants to have a try. He hands over the work of the garage to Dean. Then he buys some gifts for the boss and his wife to express his thanks for them. Afterwards, he writes Alice a letter and puts it in the drawer. The next day, Stephen thinks Alice is waiting for him at home as appointed. However, unexpectedly, Alice leaves a note saying her colleague is ill. So she decides to not go on the trip and gets on the train to the company. Seeing that, Stephen rushes out immediately, but he comes across the police at the door. Actually, the worker of the kindergarten who received Stephen's call takes him for a freak and calls the police. In order to save Alice, Stephen keeps running to get rid of the police, but when he arrives at the station, he finds Alice is getting on the train. So he immediately calls a taxi, and arrives at the potential accident site in advance. There, he finds workers who are constructing the walls of buildings also become transparent. He immediately knows that the crane will break the cable and eventually cause the train accident. Without hesitation, he rushes to the tracks with a signal stick in hand. The driver of the train immediately pulls on the brake. At this moment, the crane falls down and cuts off all the wires in front of the train. At last, the train stops. Alice and all the passengers on the train are safe, but Stephen, who knees down in front of the train, kicks the bucket. Alice is so sad. She hugs Stephen tightly for a long time and is reluctant to leave, because only she knows the truth. Actually, Alice is also the survivor of the plane accident that year. She was saved by Stephen and possesses the Fortuna's eye. After the accident, they had no contact. However, destiny makes them meet again when they grow up. After knowing Stephen had secretly saved her again, Alice fell in love with him. When she saw Stephen was becoming transparent, she knew he was going to sacrifice himself to save her. So she decided to resign to fate and get on that train. She thought her sacrifice could keep him alive. However, Stephen still died for her eventually. After Stephen's funeral, Alice comes to Stephen's to pack his relics. She discovers that letter in the drawer. She also finds a pair of rings and knows Stephen wants to marry her. Seeing this, Alice breaks out in tears with extreme grief. Though the happiness they had expected can't be realized because of Stephen's death, Alice understands that she should cherish her present time in life, because her happiness is Stephen's biggest desire. Okay, that's all for today's movie. Lastly, if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to support us by hitting the like button and subscribe by turning on the notification bell, so that you won't miss out whenever we post our new video. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.